How are you? Welcome to Comic Kong, and today we'll be looking at the DC superhero, Green Arrow.
Green Arrow is the greatest archer in the world. Now, because this is a comic book, obviously his skills have to be absolutely over the top. One thing that Green Arrow can do is, he can effortlessly split an incoming arrow in two with an arrow of his own. Although this sounds like impossible, typical comic book physics, you can watch a professional archer called Lars Anderson perform this online.
And that is the first of 100 facts about Green Arrow. Let's dive in.
Oliver Queen debuted as Green Arrow in More Fun Comics number 73 in 1941. It is also worth mentioning that this is the same issue that Aquaman debuted in. The story that Green Arrow debuted in was called Case of the Namesake Murders. Weirdly, this comic was supposed to showcase a magical superhero called Dr. Fate. However, readers gravitated towards Aquaman and Green Arrow, and Dr. Fate sank into obscurity and hasn't become popular until in recent years. The character was created by Mort Weisinger and George Papp. Mort Weisinger also created Aquaman. Papp wrote the original run of Superboy for many years. When George Papp asked DC managers for better healthcare and retirement benefits for the company's workers, he was fired. Yeah, people complain that Stan Lee got screwed over a lot as a writer, but every single comic book writer was screwed over. At least people know who Stan Lee is. Most people have never heard of George Papp, despite creating many, many iconic characters. Ollie lives in Star City. Ollie was a spoiled billionaire who never cared about anyone but himself. During a sailing trip, his assistant, Hackett, left him for dead on a remote island. Mastering a bow and arrow, Ollie stayed alive by shooting animals to eat. Ollie learned that the island he was abandoned on was used for slaves to make heroin. When he realized that drug dealers were only doing this for money and didn't care about how they obtained it, Ollie saw how selfish he had been in the past. He stopped the drug dealers, freed the slaves, and then returned to Star City to become the world's greatest archer, Green Arrow. Despite how popular Green Arrow is, he didn't get his own comic for 40 years. In the comics, he has killed at least 17 people. Ollie can shoot 29 arrows per minute. He is absolutely obsessed with chili. Green Arrow and Green Lantern joined forces in 1970. Readers love the banter between the two, since they are both as stubborn as each other. Also, Green Lantern is my favorite superhero of all time, so please let me know if you want me to do a video about him. Ollie has at least 135 different types of trick arrows. The most famous one is the boxing glove arrow. The first trick arrow Ollie ever used was a fire arrow. Green Arrow has a jack-in-a-box arrow because, you know, the reasons. He carries a paintbrush arrow. Is that in his quiver all the time? He also has a donut arrow. In what situation did he feel like he needed to make this? To distract enemies with dust, Ollie uses his tumbleweed arrow. Who even invents this stuff? He has an umbrella arrow. Okay, I'm certain that one was made up on a bet. He even has trick arrows for underwater. They're called aqua arrows. He has an electric eel arrow, a glowfish arrow, a jellyfish arrow, and an octopus arrow. Ollie Queen appeared in the famous graphic novel, The Dark Knight Returns. In this story, Ollie only has one arm. Nonetheless, he can still fire an arrow from his bow. The sequel to The Dark Knight Returns is The Dark Knight Strikes Again. In the story, Ollie has a cybernetic arm. Green Arrow's name comes from the 1940 film, The Green Archer. There's an evil version of Green Arrow called Merlin. He works for the League of Assassins, which is usually run by Ra's al Ghul. Another wordy foe of Arrow is Dracon. Dracon's reflexes are so fast that he can catch an arrow with his bare hands. This makes Arrow's archery skills redundant. Green Arrow became the mayor of Star City. One of Green Arrow's honest villains is Onomatopoeia. His name is derived from the fact that he only speaks by saying the noises around him. Blam, drip, slurp, snap. Although he's a fan favorite, he has only made a handful of appearances since his debut. It's also worth mentioning that Onomatopoeia was created by the film director, Kevin Smith. He has a baby rattle arrow. It's exactly what it sounds like. Ollie has a stepladder arrow. It shoots stepladders. I'm not sure how a stepladder could be so important in any situation you would use technology to compress it so it could fit into an arrow. The skeleton arrow is an arrow with a little skeleton carving attached to the front. This is meant to scare bad guys away. Somehow? Ollie has stated that an old-fashioned bow can weigh 70 pounds, but professionals use bows that weigh 100 pounds. But since Ollie is the world's best archer, his bow weighs 130 pounds. One of his trick arrows has a nuclear bomb built into it. You probably shouldn't have a nuclear bomb on the tip of an arrow. In fact, you probably shouldn't have a nuclear bomb on anything. Green Arrow was inspired by the 1936 radio series The Green Hornet. Like Hornet, Green Arrow is a masked vigilante who stops criminals with gadgets. Green Arrow joined the Justice League and Justice League of America number 4 in 1961. Ollie stopped being Green Arrow for a while because he was busy being dead. I'll explain that later. Anyway, while he was busy being dead, his son, Connor Hawk, became the new Green Arrow. Connor Hawk's mother is half African and half Korean. This makes Connor one of the first biracial characters in comic book history. Ollie didn't realize that Connor was his son until much later. When Ollie learned that Connor was his son, he didn't tell Connor for years. Arrow has many similarities to Batman. Both are billionaire vigilantes with no superpowers, with a cave filled with gadgets. If you think that sounds like lazy writing, it could have been worse. Like Batman, Arrow fought a clown called Bullseye. Readers saw him as a blatant ripoff of the Joker, and he sank into obscurity. Probably the most skillful thing that Ollie ever did was shoot two arrows down two different gun barrels while upside down in mid-flip while somersaulting off a building. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you can't top that. Although Green Arrow is clearly modeled off Robin Hood, he was originally modeled off Native American archers. He has a kryptonite arrow designed to take down Superman if he ever became evil. It's common knowledge that Stephen Amell plays the character in the TV series Arrow. However, you may not know that Alan Tudyk provides the voice of Green Arrow in the 2010 animated series Young Justice.
They're used as guinea pigs to create new metahumans.
And even if they test negative, they're rarely seen again.
Okay, I know Alan Tudyk is an award-winning actor and has done some incredible voice work, like K2SO in Rogue One and King Candy in Wreck-It Ralph. But to me, I will always know him as Steve the Pirate in Dodgeball. According to Elongated Man, Green Arrow wears a hat to hide his bald spot. He is nicknamed the Emerald Archer. Ollie is in love with Dinah Lance, who is better known as a superheroine Black Canary, who will make her live-action debut in the 2020 film Birds of Prey. Ollie cleans his chimney with a chimney sweep arrow. He could just use a chimney sweep. Bruce Wayne has known Green Arrow long before he became Batman. Ollie has a mummy arrow that, when fired, wraps bad guys in mummy bandages. Why would anyone invent that technology and then think, you know what's the most practical way to use this? Turn it into an arrow. Ollie has an antler arrow. It's designed to counter charging antler animals. This means that Ollie has been attacked so many times by antlered animals that it compelled him to fashion an arrow specifically to counter it. He created drill arrows from his socks to bore through coconuts. I can't believe how stupid that sentence sounded until I just said it. I can't explain every single arrow, but just quickly, he has arrows that shoot nets, tear gas, flash grenades, glue, drills, bleach, burning liquid, explosives, a buzzsaw, a flashlight, a snorkel, a tuning fork, a torch, a firecracker, handcuffs, and smoke. After many years as a superhero, he wanted to better himself and reconsider why he became a hero in the first place. He ventured back to the island where he originally became Green Arrow and was trained by an assassin called Natus. Natus trained Deathstroke, a mercenary who's considered to be one of the greatest fighters in the world. Natus trained Ollie to use hand-to-hand combat and a sword. Because of this, Ollie is one of the greatest swordsmen in the world. Ollie used his fortune to terraform land into a replica of the island that he was abandoned on. Ollie believes it is important to train and retrain in this zone as it is where he became Green Arrow. Ollie has a mind-reading arrow. It reads people's minds. It's never explained how it works. There's an analog parody of Green Arrow called Green Sparrow. He calls Superman America's dad. Ollie has a bubblegum arrow. It is the most necessary arrow ever made. A Yakuza archer called Shado found herself at odds with Green Arrow. When she realized that he had the same enemies, Shado joined forces with him. After Arrow suffered an injury, Shado nursed him back to health. That night, Shado and Arrow got down to business and conceived a son. It was this child that grew up to become Connor Hawk. In recent comics, Shado's backstory has changed. She slept with Oliver's father, Robert Queen, and conceived a daughter called Emiko. This means that Emiko is Arrow's half-sister. Emiko is a skilled archer and regularly teams up with Green Arrow. Sometimes she is known as Red Arrow. Unsurprisingly, Ollie shoots green-tinted arrows. A criminal easily framed Ollie for murder by killing people with green arrows. His ancestor, Robin Queen, founded Seattle. His mother, Moira, is a member of the Ninth Circle, a cabal that controls all criminal activities in Seattle. The Ninth Circle was founded by Robin Queen. Some people think that Green Arrow is a metahuman, which is DC's version of a mutant, which would explain how he is so good as an archer. However, there is no evidence to prove this. Ollie has a parachute arrow. Writers, are you even trying? Ollie has an ice arrow. If a criminal tries to escape while on water, Ollie used the ice arrow to freeze the water, trapping the criminal. In my opinion, this is the only trick arrow that makes sense. Although most people see Ollie as having blonde hair, he originally had brown hair. His company, Queen Industries, is one of the biggest tech companies in the world. They created their own smartphone and tablet, which are called the Q-Phone and the Q-Pad. He is as agile as an acrobat. He is a master thief and can break into the highest guarded facilities in the world. He was briefly a werewolf. That was a weird issue. Okay, let's look at his sidekick, Speedy. Roy Harper debuted as Speedy in the same issue as Green Arrow. Speedy went on to become his own superhero called Arsenal. He eventually changed his name again to Red Arrow. Over time, Speedy was revealed to be a heroin addict. This story was monumental because it showed that superheroes could have the most horrific vices, just like normal people. It even won the 1971 Shazam Award for Best Individual Story. When Green Arrow learned that Roy was taking heroin, he punched him and threw him on the street. Roy briefly went out with the villainess, Cheshire. Roy had a child with her called Leanne. In the original backstory, it was Roy that was trapped on the island, not Oliver. Although Roy became Arsenal, he still receives a Speedy costume every year from other superheroes, just to annoy him. Roy had his arm cut off by the supervillain Prometheus. A mechanical arm was built for Roy. The nerve endings didn't heal properly in his stump, so it was excruciating for the metal arm to be placed on it. Nevertheless, Roy attached the arm because he missed being a superhero. Prometheus made the electrocutioner set up a bomb in Roy's home, Star City. The explosion killed thousands, including Roy's daughter. Although Roy vowed to kill Prometheus, Green Arrow murdered him before Roy had a chance. Believing he could never avenge his daughter, he snapped and started taking heroin again. The second Speedy was Mia Dearden. She was a prostitute before she worked for Green Arrow. Mia was diagnosed with HIV. She is the first superhero to be HIV positive. Okay, back to Green Arrow. Although he usually wears an eye mask like Robin, he originally disguised his identity by smearing anchor chain grease onto his face. I'm pretty sure that was highly poisonous. In his original backstory, his parents were killed while on safari. He is an excellent bow staff fighter and can use a bow as such. He is a trained horse rider. He is an expert in judo. Ollie has a heli spotter arrow. This arrow has a helicopter propeller with three rotating mirrors attached to it. I can't even make fun of that. That's so stupid. He has many arrow-themed vehicles, including the arrow plane, the arrow copter, and the arrow mobile. Which is not a ripoff of anything. Okay, let's look at the stupidest thing Green Arrow ever did. Dying. Ollie infiltrated a terrorist group to stop a bomb from detonating. However, he got trapped on a latch seconds before the bomb detonated. Superman realized that the only way to save Ollie was to cut his arm off. Ollie refused, stating he'd rather be dead than be unable to fire his bow. The bomb exploded, blowing Ollie to smithereens. Now, superheroes die all the time in comics, but eventually come back to life. So how you come back to life after being blown up on an atomic level? Okay, there's no way you're gonna understand this. I'm pretty sure the writers don't, but I'll do my best. Look, Ollie killed Hal Jordan, the Green Lantern, after he turned evil. Trust me, it gets way more confusing than that. Over time, Hal was turned into the Spectre, which is the spirit of God's vengeance. If this gets confusing, just rewind a bit. Anyway, while Hal was a Spectre, he stopped the sun from blowing up because, you know, why not? During this time, the Spectre visited Earth and brought his friend, Oliver Queen, back to life. Now, the explanation is a bit confusing, I'll admit. But that's not even half of it. You see, Ollie was vaporized, so Spectre had to travel the world and pick up every atom of Ollie, including on Superman's cape, since he was beside him when he died, and then put all of Ollie's atoms together to bring him back to life. However, Ollie's soul was in heaven and refused to go back to Earth. Eventually, Ollie's soul decided to return to Earth because a Satanist tried to inhabit Ollie's body. So there you have it, the dumbest explanation to how a superhero came back to life. This makes a story where Robin came back to life because Superboy punched time looked like it was written by Shakespeare. Also, it's worth mentioning the Green Arrow resurrection story was written by, once again, the film director, Kevin Smith. When Green Arrow died, his identity as Oliver Queen was exposed. When he came back to life, the writers forgot this minor detail and never addressed the fact that nobody knows the true identity of Green Arrow. Which, by the way, how's that possible? His goatee is unmistakable. Green Arrow's resurrection gets more confusing when Hal Jordan sends dead Ollie to the past with Hal Jordan when he was alive over the grave of Ollie, who is dead. The two of them then have the most confusing dialogue I have ever read in a comic. Oliver says, "Hey, where are we now?" Hal, "At your grave. That's me. Shortly before I died." Oliver says, "You mean before I killed you?" Hal says, "No, I mean before I died. I didn't die until after you killed me. I didn't die until after you killed me." No matter how many times you hear that, it will never make sense. A Green Arrow film was considered in the millennium. It would have had Ollie unfairly trapped in a prison, and he would have to battle against supervillains to break out and prove his innocence. IGN ranked the top 100 greatest superheroes and ranked Green Arrow at number 30. In his original backstory, Ollie was an archaeologist who teamed up with a Native American to find a lost city of gold. Green Arrow is so skillful, he can easily shoot an arrow down the barrel of a gun. The reason why his costume is green is because he needed to blend into the forest while he was hunting on the remote island. He has a bad luck arrow, which just creates bad luck when he fires it at people. Okay, that's just magic. That doesn't make any sense. He has gun arrows, which are arrows that shoot bullets. why doesn't he just use a gun? Ollie has a fake uranium arrow just in case he sees criminals with radiation counters, also known as Geiger counters, and he wants the counters to set off a false reading. That's gotta be the most overly specific trick arrow ever. But the dumbest trick arrow has to be, and for the final fact, Ollie has a fake cat arrow. How does that even fit in his quiver?
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. If you want more facts about Green Arrow, check out my books about comics. They're all available on Amazon, on paperback, and Kindle. If you want me to do a video about any other superheroes, let me know, and I'll upload it as soon as I can.